Today, I want to share with you some easy ways for you to enhance your teaching skills on your own schedule and own terms. When it comes to our needs and weaknesses, it's up to us to take the steps to improve ourselves. Let's explore some simple methods teachers just like you are using to customize their own professional learning. First, many teachers have begun taking advantage of social media and other digital sources. Information doesn't just have to come from one source your distinct leadership decides. Information comes from nearly everywhere now, so it's important to take advantage of these resources. On social media like Twitter, Facebook, and Pinterest, teachers are sharing loads of materials, ideas, and experiences that might relate to what you're interested in learning more about. Try searching through these sources. You can search even before you set up an account and see if there's any content another teacher or organization has shared that might be useful to you. My first challenge to you is to find one idea that is useful to you and your classroom from one of these sources and then try it out. What's great about using social media is that you can access this anytime that's convenient for you and completely customize the results. Some teachers use social media all the time to cultivate ideas and share their own. Others only use it occasionally when they have a specific question or need. Consider how you might use Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, or another social media tool of your choosing to connect with fellow educators and pursue the specific information you want. In addition to social media, you can customize your professional development by searching for teachers' blogs or educational articles that share research, experiences, techniques, and ideas that might be valuable to you. Unlike district-led professional development, the internet offers a wealth of resources that you can tune in or out depending on what you're looking for. It's all about putting yourself in the driver's seat of professional development and utilizing the digital resources that help you decide what to learn and when to learn it. My second challenge for you is to find three education-related blogs, like TeachHUB.com, that get you thinking and learning. If digital resources aren't for you, then there are still plenty of opportunities for personalizing your professional development. First, take yourself to the local bookstore, library, or Amazon.com and find the latest books about education. Read as much or as little as you like, ask for recommendations, and take what you learn back to your classroom. Or, if you're more extroverted, then sign up for a local class you can take through your district or a local school that relates to ways you want to grow as a teacher. My last challenge for you is to connect with either one book or one person that can help you improve as an educator. Of course, the most important thing to remember about personalizing your professional development is that all that learning means nothing unless you apply it with your students. Just like anyone who's trying something new, there will be bumps in the road. But do take the time to access one resource that you choose about a topic that fits your needs and in a manner that fits your schedule. When you take these steps, you're no longer waiting for someone else to decide for you, but instead are taking charge of your own professional development. And how could your students not benefit from a teacher who does that?